Till now, we have talked about electrostatic field, that is Coulombian force. And Coulombian force in detail, including vector form of the Coulombian force. Now we will look forward for electric field. Do you remember gravitational field from class 11? What was gravitational field? It is a space modified around a point charge, point mass, within which it attracts and attracts other point masses. So that was natural characteristics of mass. Likewise, there is a natural characteristics of a charge. Every point charge also modifies a certain region around it. Within this region, if any other charge comes, then this charge experiences a force. Right? That I mean to say, this charge which has set up its own electric field interacts with another charge Q naught. So what is an electric field? It is a space modified around a point charge within which a point charge interacts with another test charge. This charge, because of which you are looking forward for a field, is termed as source charge. Another charge Q naught which you have kept to check whether electric field is present at this point P or not, this is called test charge. Now question arises, how do I measure the strength of electric field or electric field intensity? Another name is electric field intensity at point P. So there is a mathematical formula that electric field at a point is defined as force experienced by unit test charge. And we put limit also here. Limit Q naught tends to 0. Now question arises, why this limit? Why limit Q naught tends to 0 is put up here? Listen me carefully, I am giving you answer. As I told you, to produce electric field and generate a space around it, it is a natural characteristics of every charge. And how do we check the presence of electric field at any point? This is with the help of another charge called test charge, but practically it is a charge. So this test charge will also have its similar property. This also develops its own electric field. So electric field produced by this charge will influence electric field produced by source charge. Now what was the purpose of doing this article? To measure electric field at point P because of the charge Q. Now since electric field is a vector quantity, this becomes completely failure. So in a simple way, what is the right answer? Why do we put up a limit? We have to keep Q naught as small as possible, approaching to the zero, so that electric field produced by Q naught is negligibly small. As a result, you can measure electric field at point P because the source charge accurately. So why do we put limit? To measure, one line answer, to measure electric field at a point due to a source charge accurately and precisely. Right? That's why you put up this Q naught here. Q naught tends to 0. Let's find out electric field at a point due to point charge. Electric field at a point due to point charge. So consider a source charge Q. And point P at distance R from source charge. Place test charge to check the force. So from Coulomb's law, force acting between these two charges is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into Q over R square R cap. Therefore, electric field F is equal to, E is equal to F over Q naught. This is Q naught. So this comes out 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q over R square R cap. Now you see in this expression electric field is independent of test charge, because you have already taken test charge as very small quantity. Elaborating little more this expression, as we know unit vector R cap is equal to vector R over mod of R. This implies electric field is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q over mod of vector R cube vector R. Electric field. Now, what are the important points you can notice here? Electric field at a point follows inverse square law, similar to the Coulomb's law. Number one, electric field at a point is independent of the magnitude of test charge. Number three, it also depends on the medium between two point charges. So if I say, or changing medium from air to some other medium, so for air you can write electric field mod is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q over R square. For other medium, mod of EM is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon M Q over R square dividing 1 by 2. What you will have? EA over EM is equal to epsilon M over epsilon naught, that is relative permittivity or dielectric constant. So I have given you another formula for dielectric constant. Earlier we have expressed dielectric constant in terms of Coulombian force acting between two point charges, and now we have expressed dielectric constant in terms of electric field at a point due to point charges. Since like a force, electrostatic force, electric field is also a vector quantity, so the principle of superposition will be applicable here also. And as per the principle of superposition, you know, when do we use principle of superposition? Whenever we have system of point charges or system of point masses, and quantity is a vector quantity. So what does it state? The net electric field due to system of point charges at a point is equal to vector sum of electric field at that point due to each isolated charge. So I consider here n number of point charges q1, q2, qn, and position vectors for these charges are r1, r2, rn. Then electric field due to q1 at this point, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught q1 over r1 square r1 cap, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught q2 over r2 square r2 cap, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught qn over rn square rn cap. Just sum up, take 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught common, and then you can put a summation sign, I is equal to 1 to n qi ri square ri cap. Let me remind you again, while you are applying principle of superposition in numericals, either you should have electric field in terms of the vector format so that you can straightway use this formula. 2 point charges plus 4 coulomb and plus 9 coulomb are separated by 12 cm. Calculate the distance of a point where electric field is 0. This is one small question I am attempting. Because when you do numerical problem, and if you don't have electric field vector in the vector format, you cannot apply principle of superposition straight away. So you have to go back with the knowledge of class 11, that is vector addition and subtraction. So I say plus 4 coulomb here, plus 9 coulomb here, distance between them is 12 cm, charge A, charge B and some point P at distance x. So calculate electric field. When I say at point P electric field is 0, it means electric field because of 4 coulomb charge and because of 9 coulomb charge must be same. So electric field at A due to charge A, at P due to charge A, will be equal to how much? 4 K over X square. Electric field at P due to charge B will be how much? EB is equal to 9 K over 12 minus x whole square. Now since EA is equal to EB, this implies 4k over x square is equal to 9k over 12 minus x whole square. K cancels. Take square root of both the sides quickly. So what you will have, 2 over x is equal to 3 over 12 minus x, cross multiply it, what you will get, 24 minus 2x is equal to 3x, this says 5x is equal to 24, so x is equal to 4.8 centimeter. Is that clear? So this will be the distance from point charge plus 4 coulomb. Let's quickly have another example. Suppose we have a system of 2 point charges again. one is placed at point A, this is plus 3 microcoulomb, another is minus 3 microcoulomb, point B, distance between them is 6 cm, and this is equatorial point P at 4 cm. So find net electric field at point P. How do you find? So first assume that test charge is placed at point P. This positive charge will repel, so the direction of electric field due to charge at A will be this. Negative charge will attract positive, test charge is always positive in nature. So direction of electric field will be this. If these angles are theta, right, then this angle will be 2 theta because it is an exterior angle of a triangle. Now I can mark this central point as M. AM is equal to 3 cm, MP is equal to 4 cm. Therefore, in right angle triangle PMA, what is PA? PA is equal to AM whole square plus MP whole square, square root of this. This comes out 5 cm. Now calculate electric field. Due to charge at A, this EA will be equal to K 3 microcoulomb divided by, I say, x square, where x is equal to 5. Electric field due to charge at B, EB is equal to K 3 microcoulomb again over x square, same. These two electric fields are same. So EA is equal to EB, I say let it be x. Now these two vectors are inclined at an angle 2 theta. So using law of parallelogram, what is will be the net electric field magnitude will be equal to EA whole square plus EB whole square plus 2A EA EB cos theta cos 2 theta square root of this. So continuing with this, solving simply by putting value of x, x square plus x square plus 2x square cos 2 theta square root of this. X is outside of the square root. What is left? 2. You can take common, then in the bracket you will have 1 plus cos 2 theta. But 1 plus cos 2 theta value you can put here, 1 plus 2 cos square theta minus 1, 1 cancels. So final answer is 2x cos theta. Value of x you have already calculated and you know it. What is the value of x? X is equal to how much? K is 9 into 10 raised to power 9, 3 microcoulomb 10 raised to the power minus 6, 25 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. Right? So your answer will be 1.08 into 10 raised to the power 7 newton per coulomb. Put this value here, 2 into 1.08 into 10 raised to the power 7. Cos theta you can get from here. This is 3, this is 5. So cos theta is 3 by 5. When you calculate, it comes out nearly 1.3 into 10 raised to the power 7 Newton per coulomb. Otherwise, it comes out 1.29 something. So that's how you can attempt numerical problems. It is similar as in case of the force. Now we will talk about electric field lines. What are electric field lines? It is a geometrical path along which a unit test charge moves under influence of the electric field produced by the source charge. We know if charge is free to move under and placed in uniform electric field, it always experiences force, and the force is experienced by formula F is equal to QE. So once any particle like charge, even charge, experiences a force, it starts moving. Let's see the representation and how electric lines of force appears for different combination or single point charges. Representation of field lines. Say if Q is greater than 0, means charge is positive. When you keep test charge near here, it will be repelled this way, so move this side. If this side will, it will move this side. When you keep left downward, it moves this side, so it moves outwardly. So wherever this test charge is moving, you can show the direction of the motion of test charge. That will be the direction of electric field and or force experienced by electric field. And the path, as we are showing geometrically, this is called electric field lines. So second case we can take, when Q is less than 0, then negative charge. If you keep test charge here, test charge is always positive in nature, so it is attracted towards, so like this, electric field lines will move towards negative charge inwardly. If you keep one positive and one negative, one positive, two positive charges or two negative charges equal in magnitude, I mean to say Q1 is equal to Q2, then what will happen? This straight electric field lines will move straight because influence is less. Thereafter it keeps on turning, and it keeps on turning like this. This also almost straight, and then keeps on turning. Likewise here. In between you will have some neutral point where there is no electric field. How far this neutral point will appear? This would depend that what is the relation between the charges of two point charge. If both are equal, then this N neutral point you will obtain exactly at the center of line joining two charges. If Q1 is greater than Q2, then N point shifts towards Q2. Similarly, when Q2 is greater than Q1, the N point will shift towards Q1. If I keep one positive and one negative charge, this is a spatial structure equal in magnitude. Equation you can write Q1 plus Q2 is equal to 0. This is termed as electric dipole. Right? Then electric field lines will move like this. these lines are trying to approach from farther place, farther side, far away. Now, what are the properties of electric field lines? Number one, you can make it very clear from the figure. Electric field lines originates from positive charge and terminates at negative charge. Number two, the tangent drawn at any point of electric lines of force. Suppose this is electric lines of force and I draw tangent at this point of an electric lines of force. This will give you the direction of resultant electric field at this point. Right? Because it is a system of point charges. And the electric field are produced by positive and negative charges both. Right? Electric field lines cannot suddenly break in between, because if it breaks, it shows electric field suddenly has become zero. Two electric field lines can never intersect each other. Two electric lines of force can never intersect each other. Why? Assuming two electric field lines have intersect here at point P. Now at these two lines, field lines at point of intersection, you can draw the two tangent. Tangent 1 and tangent 2. And what does tangent at a point give? The direction of resultant electric field. Practically, it is not possible that any resultant has two directions. So, it is not possible that two electric field lines can intersect. If you find anywhere there is overcrowding of the lines like this, very close line, if you are drawing geometrically, it means here electric field is very strong. Electric field is strong, and if electric field is weak, then you have to draw these lines with a large separation. Fine. Then they tend to contract longitudinally. Another property is they exert lateral pressure on one another. From any uniformly charged surface, electric field lines always comes out perpendicular to the surface, or they get into the surface perpendicularly. I repeat it quickly, all these properties. Number one, electric field lines originates from the positive charge, terminates at negative charge. Number two, tangent drawn at any point of electric lines of force gives the direction of resultant electric field. Number three, two electric field lines can never intersect each other. Number four, any electric field lines cannot suddenly break, because it shows electric field is zero, which is not possible. Overcrowding of electric field lines shows electric field is strong, and when gap between the electric field vectors is large, means these are weak. They contract longitudinally, they exert lateral pressure, and electric field lines always act normally to the charged surface of a conductor.